the iGaze Games website has been created to work with a wide range of iGaze cameras when both the camera and website have been set up correctly to work together. The website works with your iGaze camera when you are using it to control the mouse cursor position and a left click. In this video, we will look at how to play on the site using the Irisbond Hiru iGaze camera and its EasyClick Pro software on Windows. With the Irisbond Hiru camera's EasyClick Pro software, you move your eyes to control where the mouse clicks on screen. There are different ways you can choose to do this, using the EasyClick Pro software's different modes. These modes are the left click mode, the keep left click active mode, the click with zoom mode, or the mouse movement mode. You may find that you prefer to use different options for different games, depending on the accuracy or gameplay controls required. If you have access to the EasyClick Beginner software, you may also consider this an option for playing on iGazeGames.com, so we will also cover this in this video. We will go through each of these modes and look at how they can be used with the different options available on the site, including the control scheme options and the inbuilt dwell option. There are two control schemes built into the website that you can choose between. The first option is Classic, which uses large on-screen buttons to control actions in both the 2D games, such as the board games, and the 3D games, such as Open Drive or Gazy Golf. The second option is Precise, which is more direct and often uses either smaller on-screen targets in the 2D games or uses the mouse cursor position to steer or aim in the 3D games. You can change between these two options in the iGaze settings in the controls menu on the iGaze Games site or in the top left corner of some games. Here we are using the classic control scheme on the website in some of the 2D games. These larger buttons that are spaced apart combine to allow you to control the gameplay. For instance, in chess, we select a button to choose a piece, another button to choose where it moves to, and a third button to make the move. Here we are now using smaller targets with the precise control scheme, and we can directly choose pieces on the board and then choose where to move them to. The smaller targets in the precise control scheme may allow you to play more directly and take a go with less selections, but may be more difficult to select targets due to their size and position. In the 3D games, the difference between the classic and precise control schemes isn't just the accuracy required, but also the style of gameplay is changed quite significantly too. Here is an example of using the classic control scheme in the 3D games, where we are using the on-screen buttons to steer and drive in Open Drive. And here we are using the on-screen buttons to move the camera to aim and hit in Gazy Golf. When using the precise mode in Open Drive, the vehicle will follow your gaze as you move the mouse cursor around the environment. You steer left by looking to the left of the vehicle. You steer right by looking to the right. And you go forwards by looking ahead of the vehicle. brake and then reverse, you look below the vehicle. If playing in classic mode, you will instead have on-screen buttons to select to steer the vehicle. You will first steer and choose which direction to face using the arrow buttons, and then choose to drive by selecting the button at the bottom of the screen in the center. You will then select a button in the same location to stop the vehicle before changing direction again. Similarly, in Gazy Golf, using precise mode means your aim will follow your gaze as you move your mouse cursor around the screen. Whilst in Classic, you will use on-screen buttons to direct your aim. Classic is a good place to start for many players and can be used with all of the different mouse control modes in EasyClick in both the 2D and 3D games. Though some players may like the more direct controls that the precise option offers. However, in the 3D games, not all the modes in EasyClick Pro will work with it. We will now go through the different modes in EasyClick and show how each one works with the two different control schemes on the iGaze Games website. With the Irisbond Hiru Camera's EasyClick Beginner software, you have constant control of the mouse cursor position, which means you have a few options for how you can choose to play the games. When using the EasyClick software in beginner mode, you move your eyes to move the mouse cursor around the screen and the Windows mouse cursor icon will follow your gaze. You can look at the buttons on screen to hover the mouse cursor over them, and then use the EasyClick software to left click and select these using a dwell, blink, or switch, depending on which option you have chosen to use in the EasyClick options. For instance, here, we are using the EasyClick Beginner software's dwell option, and we can look at the buttons on screen to hover the mouse cursor over them, and dwell for a set amount of time to left click and select them. When using EasyClick's beginner mode, you can also choose to use the iGaze Games website's own inbuilt dwell, which has the advantage of being centralized on the on-screen buttons. Some may find that this can help keep their eyes on a target whilst dwelling. You can find this option in the iGaze settings in the controls menu on the site or during the setup wizard. If using this feature, just turn off the dwell click option in the EasyClick software whilst using the website, so you are just using EasyClick to control the mouse cursor and not the clicks. If using the inbuilt dwell, you can also change settings related to this on the site, such as dwell time, and also whether you can make repeat selections whilst dwelling on a button, or whether you need to look away and back between each selection. With the EasyClick Beginner software, you can interact with the website and all of the games using either the classic or precise control schemes. Here we are using the classic control scheme in some of the 2D games. We are also using the inbuilt dwell, but you can also use the left click option in the EasyClick Beginner options. We use combinations of the buttons on the left and right to navigate and select pieces and where to place them. Here we are now using the precise mode in some of the 2D games, and again using the inbuilt dwell. We can directly select the piece and then select where to place them. Here we are using Classic in the 3D games and also using the inbuilt dwell. In OpenDrive, we use the on-screen arrow buttons to steer, and in Gazy Golf, we use them to aim. For the 3D games, the precise control scheme will change the style of gameplay quite considerably and let you control steering and aiming more directly. If using precise controls, you may find that adjusting the smoothing in the settings in the EasyClick Beginner software helps to make steering feel more responsive and so easier to control. Choosing very low is the most responsive when you move your gaze, making the vehicle feel like it is turning quicker. In gaze golf, using the precise controls means that your aim will follow your gaze as you move your mouse cursor. Like EasyClick's beginner mode, the mouse movement option from the Pro toolbar in EasyClick Pro will also enable you to move the Windows mouse cursor around the screen using your gaze, giving you constant control of the Windows mouse cursor position. For instance, here we are using the EasyClick Pro software's dwell option, and we can look at the buttons on screen to hover the mouse cursor over them and dwell for a set amount of time to left click and select them. As with EasyClick's beginner mode, using the mouse movement option, you can also choose to use the iGaze Games website's own inbuilt dwell, which has the advantage of being centralized on the on-screen buttons, which some may find can keep their eyes on a target to select it more easily. However, please be aware that you can't turn off the click option in the EasyClick Pro software, so your dwell, blink, or switch click will still be active in addition to the site's inbuilt dwell and may conflict. However, you are able to turn off the left click in the EasyClick Beginner software. So there may be an option for players who would like to use the website's inbuilt dwell option and with similar control over the mouse cursor to EasyClick Pro's mouse movement mode whilst playing on the site. If using the site's inbuilt dwell, the dwell time can be adjusted in the iGaze options on the website and in the setup wizard. You can also choose whether you are able to select a button repeatedly without needing to look away between selections, or whether you need to look away and back to it to make a repeat selection. As before, if using precise controls with the mouse movement mode in OpenDrive, you may find that adjusting the smoothing inner settings in the EasyClick Pro software helps to make steering feel more responsive and so easier to control. Choosing very low is the most responsive when you move your gaze, making the vehicle feel like it is turning quicker. You can also check the options within the different games to see what settings can be changed for controls and gameplay too. If using the left click or keep left click active option from the Pro toolbar, you will have a desktop gaze bubble that shows where you are looking on screen. With left click mode, you will need to select the left click icon in the Pro toolbar between selections. Whilst the keep left click active mode will not, and you will make left clicks each time you pause your gaze, until you turn the mode off. With both the left click and keep left click active modes, you will left click at the point you stop moving your gaze, using the dwell, blink, or switch, depending on which option you have chosen to use it in the EasyClick Pro software's options. You will not be able to use the optional inbuilt dwell on the site, so set this to off when setting up your controls on the Setup Wizard or Controls menu with these modes. Here we are using the keep left click active method with the EasyClick Pro's dwell option for left click. We are using this mode with the classic control scheme on the site, which can be used to interact with the on-screen buttons that can be used to control all of the games this way. For instance, here, to select the buttons, we hover our gaze over the buttons and use the EasyClick Pro's dwell option to select them to control which pieces are moved where. If using the left click, or keep left click active option, in the 2D games, such as the board games, You can also use the precise control scheme to select smaller targets on the boards themselves and control the game more directly. If using the left click or keep left click active option when playing the 3D games, such as Open Drive or Gazy Golf, you will need to use the classic control scheme, which has on-screen buttons that can be selected. If you would like to try the precise mode in these games for more direct control, you would need to use either EasyClick in beginner mode or use the mouse movement mode in EasyClick Pro, which we showed earlier. The click with zoom mode can be used to select on-screen buttons on the site, using the classic scheme in both the 2D and 3D games. You will not be able to use the optional inbuilt dwell on the site, so set this to off when setting up your controls on the setup wizard or controls menu with these modes. Here we are using the classic control scheme on the website in some of the 2D games. These larger targets use multiple steps to allow you to control the gameplay. Click with zoom mode can also be used with the precise control scheme on the site in the 2D games to directly choose pieces on the board and then choose where to move them to. You cannot use the precise control scheme with the click with zoom mode in the 3D games, as they need to reference the Windows mouse cursor position at all times. Therefore, if you would like to use EasyClick's click with zoom mode, use the classic control scheme when playing the 3D games. Here we are using the classic control scheme and using the on-screen buttons to steer and drive in Open Drive. And here we are using the on-screen buttons to move the camera to aim and hit in Gazy Golf. If using the click with zoom mode, the screen will freeze whilst you zoom. This may affect how difficult it is to control some games where timing is an element. As before, if you would like to try the precise control scheme in the 3D games, you will need to either use EasyClick in beginner mode or use the mouse movement mode in EasyClick Pro. We hope that this guide has helped with setting up the iGaze Games website to use with your preferred method of eye control, with the Irisbond Hiru's EasyClick software. You may also find it useful to explore the options within the different games to see what settings can be changed for controls and gameplay too. To try the games yourself and play for free, visit www.igazegames.com.